Hello everybody! A new version of Music Manager Pro is now available on the Mac App Store, and a new feature has been added to Music Manager Pro. The new feature is flags. You can now add and remove flags to songs, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to add and remove flags, and I'm gonna show you three different things that you can do with flags. Okay, so first in the menu song, there is new item in the menu, recall flags, because if you have some flags on songs, flags are saved. So if you quit Music Manager Pro and come back, you can restore the 10 last session. And this will restore flags for songs. There is also flag current song, command arrow up, unflag current song, command and arrow down. And if you want to flag or unflag multiple songs, you hold option key, command and arrow up. If you want to remove all flags, option key, command, and arrow down. I will give you an example. I have a song here, so I hold command key and I hit arrow up. And you can see in the title bar here, it's a sign that indicates that there is a flag on these songs. And when you see this sign, this yellow sign, this means that it's the first flag. So if I go to another song and I flag this song, command and arrow up, you see a different sign, because it's not the first flag song. So you can also use command and arrow down to remove it, command arrow up to add it. If I hit again command and arrow up, it will become the first flag song. So if I go to the first song that I flag at the beginning of the video, you see the sign is blue, because now this song is the second one. So I can flag songs like this. Command, arrow up, and so on. If I have multiple songs, I will hit the slash key, and I will type CCR, enter. I have multiple CCR songs. I can use option key, command and arrow up, and I have put a flag on all selected songs. So, and if I want to remove all those flags, option key, command and arrow down, option key, command, arrow up. And if I want to display all songs that are currently flagged, I can use the quick filter with square bracket keys. I use the left square bracket, and I have a special filter here, and I can see all songs that has a flag. If you want to quickly display this filter, you can assign a gesture to the trackpad from the Music Manager Pro preferences. Here in swipe up and down, you can assign any keys here, but personally I have set the swipe up and down, display hide list, and I have typed flags like this. As you can see here in the tooltip, you can enter played, flags, tempo, key, artist. And in my case, I want to display the list of flags. So I type flags like this. So I'm anywhere in my songs. And if I swipe with two fingers on the trackpad, I can quickly display all my flags. So now I have 8 flags and I can search any song, put a flag with command arrow up and use the two finger swipe down on the trackpad, and you can see the song here, hook, which has been added. If I return to hook and I flag it again with command arrow up, it will begin the first of the list. So if I go back into the list, I can see that now hook, it's the first one. If I want to remove it, I can use command and arrow up or arrow down, and it's now unflagged. It's not in the list. So it's the way you can use to quickly add and remove flags and display them from the list. And there is also a new object here from the window menu, new object, flags, which display the list of flags. If you make it bigger, you will see less songs in the object, but if you make it smaller, you will see more songs. So for this example, I will make it a little bigger so you can see the title. I hit command I and I use this fit width and distribute vertically. Okay, so now I have all my flags at the bottom. I can use Option key command and down to clear the list, and I go on any song, Good People. I can add a flag, hook, another flag, turn, another flag, Suspicious Mind, another flag, but I want it at the top of the list, so I flag it again, and now it's on the beginning of the list. So you can see your flags like this, and you can always use the square bracket to bring the quick filter flags, or use the gesture like I said showed before. I swipe with the two finger and I see all my flags. So it's you can use flags to flag a song, and as a reminder. And the other thing that you can do with flags is you can create you can flag some songs like this. I have 4 flags, and you can create a set list with those flags. So I click on an empty tab here, and here at the right top right of the window, only flag, and I see only the flags, and I can select like this, set to, and now I have a new set list. I can remove the flags and Option key command and arrow down, and now they are on flag. So it's the second thing that you can do with flags. Another thing that you can do is you can use flag to play to play for playback. As an example, if I have a song here, Mary the Little Lamb, and I use dot, these songs will be played. Okay. But if I can flag this song, and I will go to another one, I will flag this song, another one, and now if I hit dot to play the songs, it's suspicious mind. The playback will be suspicious mind. But if I want to use flags, I go in the genre menu and I select use flags as playback cue. I select this. Now, if I hit dot or any key that start playback, it's not suspicious mind. The playback will not occur on suspicious mind. Now the flags will be used. So if I hit dot, the program will start Mary the Little Lamb. If I hit again dot to stop, I hit dot again and it will be turn, 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 and so on. And if I have multiple songs like this, I flag them all CCR songs, and I start playback like this. I hit stop. I know that if I press dot another time, it will be cut on field. But imagine I want to overwrite this. I can search for another song, and I can flag these songs with command arrow up, arrow up. It will be the first one. So if I hit dot, this will be the songs that will be played. So I can always add the songs at the end of the queue or at the beginning of the queue. And if I don't want to add a flag to a song, but I want to play the songs now, like maybe turn, turn, turn. I know that this song is not in my queue. I want to play these songs. I want to bypass the queue. So I can hold command key and press dot. And now turn, turn, turn will be played. And at the end, when I stop this song, I press dot again, and now it will use the cue. You can also, from the general menu, you can also select continuous play. So when continuous play is selected, and if I press dot, the program will play all songs in the queue, and I can always, while the songs are playing, I can search for any song and add a flag at the beginning of the list or at the end of the list. And if I hit backspace, the program will go to the song that is currently playing, and at the end of these songs, it will be Suspicious Mind. If I want to pause the continuous playback, I can simply display the list using the equal key. When the list is displayed like this, when the songs will reach the end, I will show you. The program will simply stop. So I will have to play dot manually to begin playback. But when the list is not displayed like this, if I go at the end of the song, it will automatically play the next song. like this. So that's it. This is the new feature. I hope that you enjoy it. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Thank you. Bye-bye.